good morning. Drive time, 9. So 9. I think I ran over the morning paper. No, I think it's all right. Not the morning paper. We get a weekly town. We get 2 weekly free town papers. I don't know how they make any money, or those companies who put these two weekly papers out. We get 2 of them. They're quite lovely. You know, they sell ads, but they're not like ad laden. They're real newspapers. Some integrity, journalistic integrity, but we get 2 of them a week. It's quaint, and I do try to look at them. Not that I'm a, you know, what does it mean to be a member of a community anyway? I don't know. We'll get into that in a second, but let me first do the weather. As you can see, is blue skies. Oh, where are the clouds? I don't see any. I don't see one. I don't see a single cloud. I'll tell you something. I've been sick, as you can tell, and I don't feel it right now so bad. Obviously, I'm a little stuffy, but it's not. You know, I'm dealing right. The only times it really starts to come on is like right before I go to sleep, and then from that point on, and then the mornings are just. I wake up and I'm just a fucking mess. I can't breathe. I can't swallow. I took NyQuil last night. That seemed to knock me out. But I've been working so hard, really. You know, whatever. But it's, I got about 5 hours and 45 minutes of sleep. I gotta manage it so I get the full 6, because I definitely woke up in the middle of a cycle, a second cycle. I usually am pretty good at planning out the 6 hours, but it's hard now because I'm on, like I said, my wife's away, so I'm on dog duty. So I gotta get up for him in the morning before I go into my normal ritual. I'm a really ritual-based guy. It's the, 13th day of March, 2013. It's 8:52 Eastern Standard Time. You're in New Jersey. My name is Vernon Howell. Thank you for checking out my talk show. It's just me talking. But I was talking about community. And, you know, be living alone now that I've been for a whole, this will be my 3rd full day. And it feels like, oh my God, it feels longer than that. And I got another week and a half to go yet of this living alone lifestyle. And, you know, first of all, let me put it this way. If I didn't have a dog, I think I would lose my mind. I have neighbors who live in a duplex ranch next door, and I can hear them, and that's somewhat comforting. It's funny what used to be annoying now. I hear they're singers. They're like opera singers. I'm not kidding. They're 2 gay opera singers, which is fine. But sometimes, you know, they practice like scales and operatic scales and things like that. and every once in a while, it's, you know, it's kind of like you don't want to hear that up in your face because it can be like kind of loud. Especially if they're doing laundry, I can hear in the basement. I can hear them really, like it's in the whole my whole house. It becomes a gay opera. But look, I'm not, you know, it's, what was I saying with that? But it's just hearing people, that's slightly comforting. But that only goes so far, because I don't have really a connection with those guys. Not that I wouldn't mind, you know, but we're not friends. I'm not friends with any of my neighbors. That's what I'm saying about being in a community. I'm not part of any community. And I don't know when that stopped being a thing in this country. And, you know, I do think it's sad, and this is kind of hokey, and, like, yeah, I sound like, you know, I'm probably older than I am, and I don't want to, like, I don't hark back for, like, you know, this idea of Norman Rockwell, white American, scene. That's not what I'm talking about when I say that. It's just there's a lack of community. That's troubling, you know? And so when I glance at the paper for like 2 seconds, that I think in my head, maybe someone else around in the general vicinity is doing the same thing, it fosters a fake sense of community. That's all I'm saying. And it feels nice for like that little split second. But I don't know what's the, I don't know how to make new friends. I don't know how to branch out And, you know, I suppose that there's various, you know, I could become a volunteer fireman. Hang out with it. I mean, I imagine, like, I respect the concept of the volunteer fire department, but I imagine hanging out with those guys, you'd kind of be like, the kind of guys who actually are volunteer firemen are probably pretty awful, and it'd be really just, it would go sour fast. The first time, you know, the first political conversation, you'd be like, oh, this was a bad idea. I have some nice fake plants outside my, since I'm talking now every day, again, I should refer to that thing again. I should call it the junk spot. How about that? Does that work? Yeah, whatever. There's a bit of community right there, too. Mostly just people getting rid of their shit onto other people who are stupid enough to pick it up. It's Wednesday. I am, man. I'm looking forward to this weekend. I'm going to be run down by then, I think. Schedule I'm keeping this week. I just, you know, I make plans to try and realistically get X amount of work done in my life, and like not for lack of trying or effort. I'm not coming even close to completing it. It's just hard. It's tiring. Trying to get exercise. I don't look well. I look unwell. I feel okay, though. I feel like this is how you do it. This is how you, the only way to really fight through a cold is to kind of beat yourself into exhaustion and try and forget about it. And then, you know, when you wake up in the morning and you're still equally as sick as the day before, you're kind of like, really? How is there no improvement in here? That is odd. Common cold. I haven't had a good common cold. And people I know have been dealing with this for weeks now. It seems like a nasty cold, like a lingering cold. I haven't had one in a while. Got the flu over Christmas. That was like a 2-day flu. That was like, not the stomach flu, it was just like a regular flu that just kind of knocked out all the capacities for about 48 hours. That was a weird one. I don't know. I think I got a pretty good immune system. And this has been, Health Time with Vernon and Hal. Tune in next time when we do sex ed education.